Before you begin, remove the access panel and processor memory duct assembly. Removal. Important: when handling the processor, do not touch the processor contacts. Disconnect the CPU fan cable from the system board. Important: the heatsink has numbers adjacent to the screw holes on the heatsink. The screws must be loosened in the manner shown on the heatsink label, or the processor socket could be damaged. Loosen the four captive T30 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the processor in the sequence shown on the heatsink label. Important: fully loosen each screw completely before proceeding to the next. Carefully lift the heatsink and processor straight up off of the processor socket guide pins and remove. Carefully insert a screwdriver in between the heatsink and processor carrier on the corner identified with a screwdriver icon and the words TIM Breaker. Carefully release the remaining clips that secure the processor carrier to the heatsink and remove the processor and processor carrier. Using an alcohol swab, carefully remove the thermal grease from the heatsink and processor. Carefully release the clips that secure the processor to the processor carrier and remove the processor. Replacement. Important: when handling the processor, do not touch the processor contacts. Important: make careful note of the location of the pin 1 triangle on the processor, processor carrier, heatsink, and processor socket. Carefully place the pin 1 edge of the processor onto the retention clips on the pin 1 side of the processor carrier, and align the processor notch with the key on the processor carrier. Gently flex the processor carrier and place the remaining edge of the processor onto the retention clip, and again, align the processor notch with the key on the processor carrier. Inspect the notches in the processor to ensure they are properly aligned with the keys on the processor carrier. Apply the entire contents of 2 packets of thermal grease to the heatsink. With the pin 1 triangle on both the heatsink and processor carrier on the same corner, align the edges and openings of the heatsink with the retention clips on the processor carrier, and lower the heatsink onto the carrier. Press down firmly to secure the retention clips in the heatsink. Inspect the processor carrier retention clips to ensure they are securely seated in the heatsink. Inspect the assembly to ensure that the pin 1 triangles on the processor, processor carrier, and heatsink are all in alignment. Inspect the processor contacts for any contamination or damage. Inspect the processor socket for any contamination or damage. With the pin 1 triangle on both the heatsink and processor socket on the same corner, align the edges of the heatsink with guide pins on the processor socket and lower the heatsink onto the socket. Inspect the heatsink to ensure it is sitting horizontally over the processor socket. Important: the heatsink has numbers adjacent to the screw holes on the heatsink. The screws must be tightened in the manner shown on the heatsink label, or the processor socket could be damaged. Tighten the 4 captive T30 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the processor in the sequence shown on the heatsink label. Important: fully tighten each screw completely before proceeding to the next. Connect the heatsink fan cable into the connector on the system board.